Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is NG News with the yearly review for 2024. 2024 has been an interesting year. Four things stand out for me. First, the long-term effect of the cooperation with WIS. Second, incremental hydration is a short-term effect of that partnership. Then the work on signals and the introduction of zoneless. In March at ng-conf, the Angular team announced the cooperation with WIS. WIS is an internal framework of Google and it powers products like the Google search. WIS is not so developer friendly, but it is extremely powerful when it comes to initial loading performance. Angular, on the other side, is very good in terms of developer experience, but historically lacks this initial loading performance. The goal is to integrate WIS performance features into Angular, not the other way around. This long-term commitment of Google positions Angular to become a very important part for Google's internal projects and products. In my opinion, this action is not as much appreciated as it should be, and it really stands out from all the technical features that we got. Even for companies that don't need WIS features, it doesn't matter. Just because we get this commitment from Google makes the choice of Angular much, much safer and also future-proof. One of the first visible results of this WIS partnership is in the area of hydration. Hydration bridges the gap between server-side rendering and a fully interactive Angular application. Earlier this year, the Angular team introduced Event Replay. It addresses the uncanny valley of server-side rendering, where users are already interacting with our application, although Angular is not even initialized. Event Replay records those events and replays them once Angular is ready. In Angular 19, the game changer arrived, incremental hydration. It allows us to mark certain regions in our template and to decide criteria when they are becoming hydrated. That could be, for example, user interaction at timeout, or we can even say we don't want to hydrate at all for non-interactive regions. Angular hasn't been a good fit for internet applications that have demands for initial loading performance. Now with incremental hydration, it catapulted itself to the front, being avant-garde, and as soon as word gets around, it will become an attractive framework for a completely new market of developers and applications. It is tempting to say that 2024 was not the year of signals. We didn't really get so much new features in version 18. Effect is still in developer preview. But with version 19, we got the linked signal function and the resource pair. Linked signal is a utility function. As an alternative to the effect, it allows us to create working copies with a dependency to the original signal. Resource is more than just a nice utility function. It bridges the gap between signals and asynchronous tasks. It is one of the missing pieces we require for a holistic signals experience. Resource doesn't just return a signal. Its API also contains status information, a potential error information, a reload function, and even the option to abort an asynchronous task. Everything in the future, which will do something with asynchronous tasks and signals, will depend on that API. With resource, we see the path towards a signal-based alternative to the HTTP client. By now, we know that the name will be the HTTP resource. We also see how we can deal with asynchronous tasks without RxJS. The resource contains a switch map implementation on its own. And for those of us, for those use cases where RxJS is necessary, we can always use Rx resource. Having an experimental zoneless mode already in Angular 18 was quite a surprise. When signals arrived in 2023, Angular 16, their main selling point were to be an enabler for zoneless. That would have also required signal components, where signals are the trigger for the change detection instead of zone.js. Over time, the Angular team realized that signals and zoneless is not coupled. By slightly adjusting the behavior of mark4check, that's a function that we use for on-push components, they found a solution. Instead of mark4check, marking only a component as dirty, it now also triggers the change detection. The change to mark for check was probably much, much easier than to introduce a signal component. But it gets even better. Existing applications and libraries don't have to be rewritten. Zoneless works without signals. Applications that use already onPush for all their components might already be zoneless ready without even realizing it. Speaking of time, a question that is more and more becoming important is when will the Angular Renaissance reach its end? Since standalone components in Angular 14, every new major release brought new features. So when will we reach a state where the router, the HTTP client, the forms all are signalized and it's done? For HTTP communication, we have already seen the resource. There is now also an early branch available for signal-based forms. So we can expect for 2025 that these features will be evolved. My guess is Angular 21, maybe in developer preview, but maybe the Angular 22, which will be in 2026. But that's not the end. We will still continue. According to Minko Getchev, the Angular product lead, selectorless will become an important part in 2025. Selectorless means that we have just one import instead of two in our components, pipes, and directives. But there are also drafts for an alternative authoring format. And this is something which is planned for 2026. The alternative authoring format could be classes as it is right now, functions, or a template-based syntax, what we have in Vue. Whatever it will be, the Angular Renaissance will continue and will not end in 2025. What does this mean? All the features that I've now mentioned in 2024, they are either in developer preview or experimental. So if you have a policy where you say you are only allowed to use stable features, then you cannot even use signals right now because the effect is still in developer preview. Personally, I would consider at least to use developer preview features. You can put them into new parts of your application code or in non-critical ones. But just waiting until forms and resource are stable might take a very long time. And as Alex Rickable, and that's the Angular framework lead, put it on Reddit a few weeks ago, if he would start a new Angular project today, he would even use the resource function, although it's still experimental. And the good news is, it's the same that I said last year, nobody is forcing you to. You can use Angular 19, 20, 21 with ng-modules, with zone.js, without signals. It's really up to you. You can define the pace. And that's it. I wish you all the best for 2025 and see you in the next episode. Goodbye.